we speak of projectile motion, there are actually two types. The first type is projectile released horizontally. Okay? Meaning, yung sinasabi natin kanina na angle of release, that's equivalent to 0 degrees. So when a projectile is launched horizontally, it has no initial vertical velocity. So di ba sabi natin, lagi yung may dalawang component. Now, meron kang VI, yung, ang mangyayari dito, yung E, yung V sub IY, initial vertical velocity, 0 lagi yan. Okay? Kasi yung pag-compute natin ng V sub IY, VI sine theta. Ang sine 0 ay 0. So kung ano man yung VI mo, multiply mo sa 0, 0 pa rin ang kalalabasan. So pag ganito, horizontally launch, laging ang kanyang initial vertical velocity ay 0. On the other hand, yung atin namang V sub IX, yung horizontal component niya, is always equal to the V sub I. Kung ano yung initial velocity, yun na rin yung kanyang initial horizontal velocity. Kasi yung formula doon, V sub IX is equal to V sub I cosine theta. Cosine 0 ay 1. So 1 times VI, same value lang din. Okay? It has no initial vertical velocity. Now, this is identical to a dropped object. As you can see here, limbawa, ito yung ating cliff man yan o kung saan man yan. Ito, launch horizontally, so may force. Ito yung isa din drop lang. But as you can see, yung vertical component niya ay kapareho lang nung sa free-falling object. Affected by acceleration due to gravity, which is negative 9.8 meter per second squared. The downward vertical velocity increases uniformly. Kada segundo, 9.8 meter per second ang binibilis ng binibilis. The horizontal velocity, vertical velocity, as we have mentioned, horizontal, wala ito na, horizontal velocity, that is uniform. So kung ano yung nakuha natin na V sub IX, all throughout the flight, iisa na yung value na. Pareho na. Okay? So, points to remember, kapag horizontally launched, wala siyang vertical, initial vertical velocity, katulad yung kanyang vertical velocity ng sa dropped object. Yung vertical velocity niya increases uniformly, pabilis ng pabilis, following the acceleration due to gravity. And then yung kanyang horizontal velocity, that is constant, pareho. Let's have the second type, projectile launched at an angle. So this time, hindi na zero yung kanyang angle of release. Ayan na, may specific na angle. Say 45, 50, hanggang 90 degrees. Now, in situations like this, the velocity already has two components. Kanina, isa lang. Ano? Kasi yung isa nga, ang kanyang initial velocity ay zero. But for this, the velocity has two components. First would be a constant horizontal velocity. So kung ito yung ating initial position, di ba meron nga tayong V sub IX, V sub IY. Itong V sub IX na yan, ganyan natin kanina, pare-pareho yan all throughout the flight. Hindi yan nagbabago. On the other hand, you have the upward positive vertical velocity sa una, nasabi natin affected by the acceleration due to gravity na negative 9.8 meter per second. Nasabi nga natin, until such time, pagdating sa peak, ano mangyayari? Yung kanyang velocity will be equivalent to 0 meter per second. And then, after niyang mag-zero, makaka-experience naman siya ng downward vertical velocity or negative vertical velocity. So, hilayin siya pababa, mag-i-increase yun, but with a negative sign. Okay? Now, another thing to remember, kapag ganito, na sa type 2, launch at an angle, for a projectile beginning and ending at the same height, so magkapantay, ano, the time it takes a projectile to rise to its highest point, itong time na to, bago siya nakarating doon sa highest point, that is equivalent to the time it takes to fall from the highest point back to its original position. So from highest point pababa naman, doon sa kabilang side, that is the same. Ano, let's say, it took the object, let's say, 1 minute para makarating doon sa highest point. From highest point pababa, 1 minute ulit yun. They're always equal. Of course, neglecting air resistance. Okay? Now, in computing, in solving problems related with projectile motion, we make use of this set of formula. So, kanina, na-introduce ko na sa inyo yung ilan. Ano? Pagkuha ng initial horizontal velocity, ito yung pinakita ko sa inyo kanina, V sub I cosine theta, at pagkuha ng initial vertical velocity, V sub IY is equal to VI sine theta. Now, itong mga ito, magagamit natin siya if we want to get the other values. Saan tumutukoy yung mga yan? Yung D sub X that pertains to the range. Ano, horizontal distance. V sub I, initial velocity. Pinakita ko na rin kanina, no? V sub I, X, initial horizontal velocity, kaya I. Ngayon, kapag ang pinag-uusapan naman natin ay final horizontal velocity, na alam natin equal lang naman sa initial, V sub FX. So, F na ang ginamit. Ito, at T sub, yung capital T, that is the total time of flight, and then yung theta, that is the angle of projection or release. Now, for the vertical motion, yung D sub Y, this is your height. In other references, minsan H. Itong D sub X, in other references, R naman ang ginagamit, capital R. V sub IY, initial vertical velocity. V sub FY, this is the final vertical velocity. G would be the acceleration due to gravity, which is equal to negative 9.8. Huwag kakalimutan yung sign. And then yung small letter na T, walang subscript, that is the time, simply the time of flight. Okay? Now, let us try solving problems involving projectile motion. So, let's try this one. If a bullet is fired with a speed of 600 meters per second horizontally, take note of that, from a height of 48 meters, how long will it take to hit the ground? What is the range of the projectile? Assume that there is no air resistance. So, in solving problems like this, it's important for us to visualize kung ano ba yung nangyayari dun sa problem. So, para ma-visualize, kailangan tayong mag-drawing. So, bullet at a height, di ba? So, let's say, halimbawa lang building, nandun halimbawa yung tao, may hawak na barrel, and then you have there the bullet. So, sabi dyan, ang initial speed is 600 meters per second. What other given values do we have? Height, D sub Y is equal to 48 meters. So, negative to, kasi yung motion ng bullet pababa yan. So, let's make it negative. Negative 48 meters per second. Now, ano yung hinahanap sa atin? How long will it take to hit the ground? We're asked to find the time and the range. Ito, gaano daw ba kalayo? Yun. So, na-visualize na natin. Isulat natin formally yung mga given values. You have 600 meter per second. This is your initial velocity. Now, this is horizontally launched. Gaya na natin kanina, kapag horizontally launched, yung ating V sub I, yun na rin yung V sub IX. Ano? Saan natin nakuha yan? Kasi yung V sub IX, that is V sub I cosine theta. Ang cosine theta natin ay 1, so 1 times 600, yun lang din yun. Now, we have negative 48 meters, this is your D sub Y, and then of course, huwag kakalimutan, negative 9.8 meter per second squared, this is the acceleration due to gravity. Kapag velocity speed, meter per second lang. Kapag may squared, that is for the acceleration. Now, ano yung inahanap natin? We're asked to find the time as well as the range or D sub X. Anong formula ang ating gagamitin dito? So, dito muna tayo sa time. Anong formula yung gagamitin natin? So, titingin tayo dun sa list ng ating equation kanina. Ano? So, ang hinahanap natin ay time. Wala tayong D sub X. Ano? So, given the given values, dapat makahanap tayo dito ng equation na isa lang ang missing quantity. Yun lang hinahanap natin. Kapag kasi dalawa yung nawawala, ano, given yung ating mga given values, natin mahahanap yung ating hinahanap na quantity. So, in this case, wala pa tayong D sub X. So, magiging dalawa yung missing quantity na pwedeng gamitin ito. In this case, meron tayong D sub Y, yung kanyang height, meron tayong acceleration due to gravity. Itong isa, may time din, kaya lang wala pa tayong final. So, best na magamit natin itong isa. So, sulat natin. Formula would be, D sub Y is equal to V sub IY times time plus GT squared over 2. Yung formula, let's have the solution. Pwede nyong i-derive muna yung formula. Ito kasi ang hinahanap natin, itong time. Or pwede rin naman na ipasok na sa ating formula, yung given quantity. So, Let's substitute the given values. You have d sub y negative 48 meters, right? Is equal to v sub iy, kapag horizontally launched, di ba laging 0? So 0 times kung ano man yung time, 0 pa rin ang kalalabasan. That's why we will cancel this out. So wala na yan. Diretso na tayo dito. G is equal to negative 9.8 meter per second squared times yung hinahanap natin, t squared over 2. So kailangan natin ma-isolate ito on one side. Pwede tayong mag-cross multiply. 2 times negative 48, you have negative 96 meters. Is equal to 1 times this, so same pa rin. Negative 9.8 meter per second squared times t squared. Kailangan ma-isolate pa rin si t squared. We will have to divide both sides by negative 9.8 meter per second squared. In this case, wala na to. T squared na lang matitira. Then, yung meter maka-cancel out. Negative 96 divided by negative 9.8, you have 9.8. Mawala na rin yung negative sign. Ano? So you have here, negative 9.8 s squared na lang. And on one side, you have t squared. So ito na ba yung ating answer? Naka-square pa rin yung time. So kailangan, t lang ang matitira. So, para mawala yon, we will have to get the square root of both sides. So, mawala na yung square. Mawala na yung square ng ating second here. So, square root of 9.8. Wala na pala yung negative. Ano? Burahin ko yung negative sign. Negative divided by negative. Positive na yon. So, square root of 9.8. That is, you have here 3.13 seconds. So para pala makarating yung bullet na yon from this dun sa landing point niya, that will take it about 3.13 seconds. Okay? So that's basically how we compute. Pero isa pa rin nakuha natin, yung time. Tinatanong pa tayo ng d sub x. So, ito naman, ano gagawin natin na formula? Nagdagdagan na, bukod dito sa ating given values, meron pa tayong time. Let's take a look at the formula. So, d sub x ang hinahanap natin, may v sub ix naman tayo, may time na rin tayo, pwede na natin itong gamitin. Let's write this formula. D sub x is equal to v sub ix times time. O, substitute lang para sa solution. D sub ix, v sub ix rather, you have 600 meter per second times the time, 3.13 seconds. So, 600 times 3.13, that will give you about 1,878 meters. Okay, so yun pala yung layo dito. So, probably, mapapansin nyo, medyo may iba yan ng kaunti dun sa nasa module. But this has to do with the rounding off of the answers. Ano, pero malapit pa rin naman. Kapareho pa rin. Okay? Now, let's try another problem. So, second sample problem. A soccer ball is kicked horizontally from a cliff with a velocity of 16.5 meters per second. The ball falls 35 meters away from the cliff's edge. How long before the ball hits the ground? How high is the cliff? Cliff dapat ito, no? And what is the ball's velocity just before it hits the ground? So again, ang key dito, dapat ma-visualize natin yung ating solve na problem. Para magawa yun, mag-drawing ulit tayo. So nasa taas daw ng cliff, alas 12 na. Launch, yung ating soccer ball was kicked horizontally. Ang kanyang initial velocity ay 16.5 meter per second. So ano pang given values natin? You have the range binigay, falls 35 meters away from the cliff's edge. Meron daw kalayo, so yun yung ating range. 35 meters. Tayo, how long before the ball hits the ground? So, yung time, uli. How high is the cliff? D sub y. At ano daw yung, what is the ball's velocity just before it hits the ground? So, we're being asked the final vertical velocity. So, ito yung mga kailangan nating hanapin. Sulat natin specifically yung mga given values. 16.5 meter per second. You have your VI. Horizontally launched. Kaya ito na rin yung V sub IX. Okay? Pero pag hindi horizontally launched, gagamitin natin yung formula na introduce ko kanina. You have here 35 meters. This is your D sub X. And then, huwag kalimutan, negative 9.8 meter per second squared. This is your acceleration due to gravity. So, we're asked to find the time, the D sub y, and your final vertical velocity. So, dito muna tayo sa una. This is your A, this is your B, this is your C. Sa A tayo. Anong formula ang gagamitin natin? We will have to get first the time. Meron tayong D sub X, meron tayong V sub IX. So as you can see, pwede natin itong magamit. Okay? So sulat na natin. We have D sub X is equal to V sub IX times the time. So for the solution, atin lang i-substitute. D sub X natin is 35 meters is equal to V sub IX 16.5 meter per second times the time. Kailangan ma-isolate si time on one side. So let's divide both sides by 16.5 meter per second. So we'll be left with time. Wala na to. So makakancel yung M. Second na lang matitira. You have time is equal to, just the answer, 35 divided by 16.5. You have 2.12 seconds. So, the time it will take for the ball to reach from this initial position to the final position, that's about 2.12 seconds. Okay, so nakuha na natin yung una. So, hopefully, nakasunod. Ano, let's have the second one. Yung kanya naman daw na taas ng cliff. So, given all this, given quantities, plus yung bagong kuha natin, tingin tayo dito, ano yung pwede natin gamitin. Dapat, yung formula na yon, yung ating hinahanap, yun lang yung missing quantity. Okay? So, alin kaya dito? Hinahanap natin D sub Y, so maalin sa tatlong ito. Meron tayong V sub Y, I, ito naman, cancel na to kasi zero lagi. Kapag horizontally launched, ano? Meron tayong G, meron din tayong time. So, pwede na ito. Ito na ang pinakamadali sa kanila. Wala pa tayong final. Ito, pwede rin, ano? Pero dito na tayo sa una. So, we have here, D sub y is equal to V sub I y t plus g t squared over 2. This is the formula. For the solution, hinarap natin ay D sub y, so we'll leave that blank. V sub I y times time, ito ay 0. So 0 times time, 0 pa rin. So we cancel this out already. Dito na tayo agad. So negative 9.8 meter per second squared times the time, which is 2.12 seconds squared divided by 2. So, multiply natin. 2.12 squared times 9.8, negative 9.8, so negative 44 point, negative 44.05, S squared na rin to, so makakancel na natin to, itong dalawa. M na lang ang matitira. Divided by 2, you will have 22. The answer is, the D sub y is equal to 22.02 meters. Negative. Ano? Negative 44 divided by 2. So, negative pa rin. Ito yung kanyang D sub y. Negative 22.02. Yun yung ita-travel. Ano? Noong ating projectile pababa. Direction downward kasi siya. Okay? Kaya siya naka-negative. So, now, let's have the last one. V, ito namang yung A, ito yung B. Let's have the C. Itong ating V sub FY, final vertical velocity. So, maalin, pwede natin magamit dyan. Meron na naman tayo nito. Meron tayo ng mga ito. Kaya lang ito, magsisquare ka pa eh. Ito na gamitin natin. So, formula, you have V sub FY is equal to V sub IY plus GT. Ito naman ay 0, so cancel that out. So, you have GT, negative 9.8 meter per second squared times the time, which is 2.12 seconds. So, maka-cancel natin yung isang second kasi meron ka dito. So, meter per second na lang, negative 9.8 times 2.12, that will give you negative 20.78 meters per second. That's the final vertical velocity. Bago mag-hit ng ground, ito yung kanyang final velocity. Okay? So, negative to denote that the direction is downward. Okay? So, that's basically how we compute problems involving projectiles. So, depende sa kung anong hinihingi, edi yung gagamitin natin na formula from the list. Okay? The motion of a projectile may actually be described in terms of the range and the maximum height it reaches. So, a while ago, we've already defined these two terms. As we mentioned, the range is the horizontal distance traveled by a projectile. Okay? Whereas height, that is the vertical distance traveled by a projectile. Now, what affects these two quantities, the range and the height? Paano magiging mas malayo o mas mataas yung maaabot ng projectile? Well, of course, syempre, isip nyo siguro yung initial velocity. Pag mas mataas yung initial velocity, mas malayo at mas mataas yung mararating niya. Probably that has to do with the force that you've exerted. But what if the initial vertical velocity or let's say the force applied is the same? Ano pang ibang factor yung makaka-apekto sa dalawang ito, sa range at sa height ng isang projectile? Well, one factor that affects that would be the angle of release or the angle of projection. Now, I want you to take a look at this illustration that we have on the screen. The height and range of a projectile launched at the same initial velocity but different projection angles. Okay. So, I want you to focus first on the angle of release and the height. Which angle resulted to the highest or to the greatest height or highest peak? These are the angles, 15 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, and 75 degrees. So which angle resulted to the greatest height or highest peak? As you can see, 75, that is the one with the highest peak, while 15, that is the one with the lowest peak. Nandyan. Okay? Now, this time, let's focus on the range. The angle of projection and the range, the horizontal distance traveled, yung layo. So, which angle resulted to the farthest range? Still the same angle. We see here, 45 degrees, right? Mabot siya ng 20, whereas itong 60 hanggang dito lang sa 10, 60 hanggang dito lang sa 17, si 75 hanggang 10 lang, si 15 hanggang 10 lang din, si 30 hanggang 17 din. So, ano yung nakuha natin dito? So, definitely, the angle of release affects both the height and range of a projectile. So, if the initial velocity is kept constant, ito yung factor na makaka-apekto sa kung gaano kalayo, gaano kataas yung maaabot ng projectile natin. So, in terms of height, for projectiles launched at a constant initial velocity, the steeper the angle is, meaning the closer it is to 90 degrees, yun yung 90 degrees natin. Ano? The closer the angle is to 90 degrees, the greater is its maximum height. As you can see, kaya yung 75, siya yung pinakamataas. Kapag tinaasan pa niya yung angle dyan, pwede pang maging mas mataas yung peak. Yan. Well, what is the reason behind this? This is due to the fact that as we increase the angle of release, the time of flight also increases, which results to higher peak. mas mababa naman yung angle of release mo or angle of projection, mas mababa yung time of light, mas mababa rin yung magiging peak. Tulad ng nakita natin sa ibang mga angles na nandito. Now, what about angle of release and the range? Well, in terms of range for projectiles launched at constant initial velocity, pare-pareho pa rin initial velocity, the optimal angle of release is as 45 degrees. As you can see here, siya yung pinakamalayo. Okay? If a projectile is launched at an angle greater than or less than 45 degrees, it will result to a much shorter range or horizontal distance. Ano pang napansin nyo dito? Meron bang mga angles na nag-result sa magkaparehong klase o magkaparehong layo in terms of range? 60, 17. 30, 17 din. So what have you observed with regards to these two? So these two are actually what we refer to as complementary angles. Ito yung mga angles na pag pinag-add natin, the result will be 90 degrees. Ano? You have your 60 plus your 30. That's 90 degrees. Itong mga complementary angles na to, pareho siya ng kinakalabasan na range. So parehong 17. Alin pa yung ating complementary angles dito? You have your 75 and your 15. Kaya pareho sila. 75 plus 15, 90 degrees. Parehong nasa 10 yung kanyang range. Okay? So, definitely, the angle of release affects both the height and range of a projectile. Now, how do we apply this in daily life, in sports, and other activities? So, what is the activity shown here? We show here our cherry, right? Now, ano yung, paano may-apply yung concept ng projectile dito? Kapag na-target mo yung gitna, paano dapat? Dapat ba directly ka na mag-aim? Mas mababa o mas mataas? Siyempre, dapat mas mataas because it is affected by the acceleration due to gravity. Kapag sakto yan, ay di ang mangyayari, bababa pa yan. Ano? Because of the action of the acceleration due to gravity. Kaya dapat, you've got to aim it a little higher para dun pa rin siya tumama sa iyong target. Shooting, ano, ganyan din ang application. Now, in sports, in other sports, let's say in throwing activities, javelin throw, shot put, ano, so aside from the force, kasi ang goal dito, malayo yung marating nung ihahagis na object. So, pahabaan ng range. Ano, aside from the force that you've got to apply, you've got to consider as well the angle of projection para maabot mo yung pinakamalayong range. Okay? So, ilan lang to sa mga application, but as you can see, there are a lot of applications to this in real life. So far, we were already able to describe the horizontal and vertical components of a projectile, and we were as well able to see already the relationship between the angle of release and the height and range of a projectile. So kung may tanong, pwedeng balikan yung mga parts na yun ng video na medyo nahihirapan pa, at kung may mga hindi pa rin maintindihan, you can leave your questions in the comment section. So maraming salamat and see you on our next video.